Hey, Brent.
Oh, hey, Mega. Great to see you. Beautiful weather we're having up here today, huh?
Definitely. Are you in VR headset?
I am in a VR headset. Are you on PC then?
Yes.
Ah, it's great that we can collaborate together immersively on PC and in VR inside a Microsoft Mesh. What do you say we hop out of here for a minute and tell our viewers about our product?
Let's do it.
All right. We've seen some of our early partners build solutions that target scenarios such as employee onboarding, training, social gatherings, and more.
With Mesh, you get a lot of out-of-the-box functionality. You get a built-in avatar system, you can use different input devices, and it also comes with spatial audio. So there's a lot that just comes with Mesh, but there is a lot of room to add your own magic to build custom experiences.
That's right. We have developer tools so that you can bring things like web content into your experience, physics for real-world-like interactions, scripting that can actually connect to your business logic on the back end, and performance tools to make sure things work great on Quest. So when you're building custom experiences, you know they're going to be great. Let's jump over into Unity so we can show you how to use these developer tools.
Let's do it.
So what we have here is a scene in Unity that we can use to build experiences inside of Mesh. Now we want to understand, is our scene, are we looking down at it from up here? Or are we down here on this little boat sailing to this island, or are we somewhere in the middle? Well, for this experience, we're actually going to be somewhere in the middle. And to help you understand what your experience looks like for that scale, we can go to Mesh Toolkit and add our play mode setup, and we get this little dev person who's about person height, and we can use them to design our experience around a certain size. Now that they're in here, we can see what things will look like, and let's say we want to add some web content. So we'll go ahead and go in here back to Mesh Toolkit, add a web slate. And once this web slate is in here, we can position it where we want it, make it the size that we want it, add the content to it that we want down here. You just enter the URL you want. This one I'm going to take us to the Mesh homepage because everyone wants to see the Mesh homepage. And then when you get in your play mode, you can see that content interact in here and test things out. But before we do that, we would want to go through into this tool down here, our content performance analyzer, and make sure our environment's going to perform well inside of Mesh. So to do that, we just click Run All, and that will go through and it looks at the scene and analyzes some different things in here and lets us know, did we pass? Do we have some warnings? Are there some things that just aren't working? And we can go in here and see, okay, we've got some issues we can fix. Some of these things can be fixed automatically, some cannot, but we try and make it as easy as possible for you to bring your environments inside of Mesh.
Cool. Awesome. Thank you, Brent, for showing us that. With those steps, we'd have an environment ready to party in and Mesh. You can bring your coworkers. What I'm going to do is take it a step further to add some magic and interactivity to the scene using visual scripting. So what we're looking at here is a teleport button. What I want to do is have my users click that button and teleport to the top of this generator, which my technical artist has added an animation to, which is pretty cool. So let's open this button. And what we're going to do, like I mentioned, is use visual scripting to make this happen. So let's edit our embedded graph right here. And we already have some logic written out. What this teleport button behavior logic is doing, for those familiar with visual scripting, is it's just saying that if you click on this button, something is going to happen. Now it's our job to set what that something is. So we want to get to the top of that platform. So let's go into our travel group points over here. You'll see I have some other travel points already set up. What I'm going to do is create another one and call this teleport location wind turbine. Make sure not to have any typos there. And I already have my position in mind, so let me just add that in. And we'll set the rotation to 270 because I want to make sure the avatar is facing the generator, which is located right here. So I have that travel point added. What I need to do is add this travel point script. What I need to also do is unselect this point. What you'll notice here is this location is selected because it's activated as the spot where our avatars are going to spawn into. I don't want my avatars to spawn into the top of the turbine when they first join the event. I just want to set this as a travel point. So we can call that into our visual scripting here. So what I'm going to do is activate my game object. There we go. and call in this location. And I'll press this value to activate this as well. And then I need to add a special travel point script. As you can see, there's a bunch of different options that you can use to customize this experience. In this case, I have a specific point that we've already made, so I'm going to drag this in right here. Awesome. So what's happening in this logic right now is this has been set to true so that this, when the button is selected, I'm teleporting to the top. However, I want to reset this back to false so that the next time I press the button, I can teleport again. I don't want this to be just a one and done deal. So I am going to connect this logic here. And there we go. We'd have our travel teleport button working. And we can test this out by going into play mode. While play mode loads here, I'll tell you a little bit about what we're looking at. This is Mesh 101. It is our developer tutorial that's designed to guide you through basic building blocks of what it is like to build for Mesh. So for example, we have an information dialogue trigger. We have this teleport button right here. We have video player as well. And it walks you through how to build these things in Unity for an experience in Mesh. Awesome. So let's check out if this button works. Great, we've made it to the top of the turbine. Like I mentioned, there is an animation here that our tech artist has set up, so we can go ahead and look into this generator. And that's it for our work in Unity regarding visual scripting. Awesome, we've made it to our physics interactivity station. With physics, you can control things like grabability, gravity, buoyancy, and throwability. This is a super simple example where these blades start moving when we bring them into the ocean wind. Now there's one turbine that's not moving, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to make that turbine grabbable and releasable. I just have to bring in my mesh interactable property script, turn this on, and make it manipulable. There's a bunch of different settings that I can use and customize the experience, but that's how simple it is to make it grabbable and releasable. Now I think Brent is already in mesh partying with these turbines, and I really want to head over there. We have an environment that's already published, so let's jump right into mesh. Hey again, Brent. Good to see you playing with the turbines.
Yeah, good to see you too. You know, something I really like about Mesh, we have the developer tools that we've shown you today, and also we have all the stuff that comes with Mesh out of the box, like this avatar system and spatial audio, comes together to create a truly unique product. And if you all want to learn more about Mesh, you can follow the link in the description. And if you want to keep up with M365, you should subscribe to the channel. Now, I'm going to head back over here to the turbines.
Thanks for listening, all. See you in Mesh.
Bye.